Arriving in St. Petersburg, former Prime Minister Ruhakana Rugunda, who is representing President Museveni in the mediation talks, was received by the ambassador of Uganda to Russia. Dr. Rugunda will join other African leaders from six countries scheduled to meet Russian President Vladimir Putin to discuss a potential peace plan to resolve the conflict. Museveni was unable to travel because he's in isolation at Nakasero State Lodge as he heals from COVID-19. On Friday, the African leaders delegation, led by South African President Cyril Ramaphosa, held talks with Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky in Kyiv, where they urged the two warring countries to settle the war through negotiations and diplomatic means. President Ramaphosa voiced concerns that the conflict is affecting Africa negatively and that there was a need to de-escalate it.
This war must be settled, and there should be peace through negotiations and diplomatic means.
This high-level African delegation had prepared to meet with Russian President Vladimir Putin on Saturday, a day after its calls for talks between Moscow and Kyiv were rebuffed by Ukrainian leader. Zelensky ruled out that possibility during a joint press conference with the delegates. Ramaphosa, however, took the barrage as evidence that both sides needed to stop fighting. It seems to me that this person, Putin, is inadequate because this person is not ready to see peace. This person wants to wipe off and fully destroy the country of Ukraine. If these are this person's intentions, then I have a lot of questions as to what talks and what dialogue can be with this person. The African delegation had gone first to Bucha, a town outside the capital that has become synonymous with alleged war crimes carried out by Moscow. The group includes four presidents: Ramaphosa, Senegal's Macky Sall, Zambia's Hakainde Hichilema, and Comoros's Azali Assoumani, who also currently heads the African Union. The leaders of Uganda, Egypt, and Congo Brazzaville pulled out of the visit at the last moment and sent representatives instead. The meetings come as Ukraine announces gains in a new counteroffensive, but Putin claims that Kyiv's forces stand no chance in the sectors where fighting has intensified.
We are here to listen both to President Zelensky, and tomorrow we'll be listening to President Putin, and we do so with deep respect for the people of Ukraine, which we have expressed to President Zelensky, but also in recognition of the proposals that they have put forward as a peace formula.
Speaking at an annual economic forum in St. Petersburg on Friday, Putin displayed little appetite for peace talks, announcing the deployment of nuclear weapons in Belarus while also calling Zelensky a disgrace to the Jewish people. The African continent has been badly hit by rising grain and fertilizer prices, as well as the wider impacts on global trade since Russia invaded Ukraine last year. African nations have been divided over their response to the war, with some siding with Ukraine and others remaining neutral or gravitating towards Moscow. South Africa, for one, has drawn scrutiny for refusing to condemn the offensive launched by Moscow.